Guys, sometimes doing what's good for the environment or for your health can be really difficult. I get that. Breaking old habits is hard. But then there are other situations where the right choice is so mind-numbingly simple, so incredibly obvious, and so easy that there's no excuse not to. Using products that contain these things called microbeads fall into the category of, oh my god, that's so evil, I can't believe anyone, including myself, would have ever used those. Microbeads are these tiny plastic pieces that can be found in face washes, exfoliant scrubs, even toothpaste. When you wash that soap off your face in the shower, or you spit your toothpaste down the sink, those tiny plastic pieces go on an adventure. They head down your drain, Finding Nemo style, and often end up in the ocean or some other nearby body of water. These beads are often small enough that they can navigate straight through water treatment plants without getting filtered out with the rest of the waste, and then they end up as fish food. But why would a fish eat plastic? Well, A, fish aren't very smart, and B, those tiny plastic beads look an awful lot like fish eggs, which are the favorite snack of most water dwellers. So suddenly, you've now got fish eating plastic, which can have a whole host of problems. For starters, on the off chance that you haven't been chewing on your phone case recently, plastic doesn't digest very well. In some cases, it can get stuck in the digestive tracts of fish and birds and really wreak havoc in there. Some of these plastics can also act as endocrine disruptors, which means that they can screw up a creature's reproductive habits, which is always problematic both for that species and for the ecosystem as a whole. Then there's all that plastic and the toxins associated with them in our food chain. Those tiny plastic beads kind of act like sponges in water for all sorts of toxins like polychlorinated biphenyls, DDT, polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, or any other hydrophobic pollutants. Imagine this, that little microbead gets eaten by a tiny little fish, but that tiny little fish gets eaten by a little bigger fish, and that slightly bigger fish gets eaten by an even bigger fish, which you in turn eat. As we move up the food chain, the toxicity of that tiny little microbead can potentially get much stronger. Why? Now think about how many of those little tiny fish the slightly bigger fish had to eat in order to get all the nutrients it needed. Now think again about how the even bigger fish, how many of the slightly bigger fish it had to eat to get all its nutrients. This is called biomagnification, which poses a serious threat for those animals at the top of the food chain, which includes things like hawks, eagles, seals, and people. We're talking birth defects, developmental disabilities, and even cancer. Plus, it's frickin' plastic. We're washing tiny plastic beads down the drain and sending them off into the oceans, or the Great Lakes, or the nearby riverbeds. It's like if you took your face wash when you're done and threw it out on the sidewalk. That's called littering, it's bad for the environment, and fortunately, it's frowned on in most places. What's great is that many states have started to realize that these products are A, not useful for people, and B, kinda suck. And by kinda, I mean super suck. So they're starting to ban it, which is great, but it's not illegal everywhere. So we gotta remember to always check the ingredient list before we buy. If you're seeing things like polyethylene or polypropylene, don't buy it. There's also this pretty neat app called Beat the Microbead, which you can download to the smart device of your choosing, which will let you take a scan of the barcode right there in the store of the product and tell you if it's got microbeads in it. But hey, if you want a super cheap alternative exfoliant scrub, try this. Go out and buy raw cane sugar or brown sugar, whatever you can find that's got the biggest crystals possible. Mix that with some olive oil and the essential oil flavor of your preference. I'm a fan of lavender personally. Mix that all up and you've got a slightly tasty, although I would not recommend eating it, very effective, and most importantly, lake and ocean friendly exfoliant. Seriously, that stuff is great. Your skin feels brand new. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. Leave me a note in the comment down below if you think there's a topic I should cover, or let me know your alternatives to microbeads. I would love to hear it. Feel free to watch any more of my videos, subscribe if you like all this, want to see more of my face, and have a great day. Bye!